you don't, I have to leave. Oh no, I am free, yeah, yeah, come water me. Oh, oh, love you so, but if you don't, I have to leave. Oh no, woo, it's hot. I think I wanna kick off both of my sides. I can feel it boiling up in this pot. A closed mouth don't get fed, is you hungry or not? Like, brr, brr, operator, caboose like choo-choo. Bless my trainer, thank God, thank God, thank God. I'm getting thicker. Give me that sweet tea, you think I'm playing? I need it all night, no sleep. You can get it in the kitchen if it's sweating at the sheets. Like, brr, brr, operator, you got me like, hee-hee, Mike Jackson. Thank God, thank God, thank God, I'm getting thicker. And I can make you boil up, baby, let it simmer.
Hi, everyone, and welcome to our Career Steps in Skincare and Cosmetics with Say Moi. I'm so happy to have you all here with us and excited for today's session. We'd love for you all to introduce yourselves and let us know where you're calling in from over in the chat box, and let us know what you are most excited to gain from today's session. All right, so while you all are doing that, and before we sort of officially begin, I'd love to share a few friendly reminders. So we'd like to ask that everyone who is able to turn on your videos to please do so. Even though we're not physically in person, we do love to create that feeling, and having the cameras on sort of supports us in creating an intimate, safe, and brave space for everyone. All participants' mics will be or should be on mute until we go into our breakout sessions. So feel free to add in the meantime any positive comments and reactions in the chat box at the bottom of your screen. And then finally, we are asking everyone to take a moment right now and adjust their display name to reflect three things. And that's going to be your name, your role, and your pronoun. So you can see a few examples there on the slide on what that looks like. This part is really important because it does help us later on when we're going to break everyone into smaller groups. So please make sure to do that right now. And in case you need some help with that, if you're on your phone, if you click on participants, you can click on your name and it will give you the option to rename. If you happen to be on a laptop or a desktop, you can click the three dots in the corner of your profile to rename, or you can click on participants and rename yourself that way. Additionally, if you need any support with anything at all throughout the event, say for example, you need extra help in renaming your or changing your name, please feel free to message Morgan in the chat. Her username should say Morgan-she, so she can help you out with anything. All right, so up next are our objectives. So our goal is for you all to express your voice among your peers and your mentors and increase your belief in your personal ability to shape your own path. You all will connect with, listen to, and learn from industry experts in order to build knowledge of life paths and professional opportunities available. And finally, our goal is for you all to increase your knowledge about the skincare and cosmetic industry. All right. So here's how we're going to do that. Here's our agenda. So in a few moments, we're going to do a whole group icebreaker. After that, I'm going to lead us into, or we're going to go into a company overview where you get to learn more about Say Moi and just the industry in general. Then we're going to go into smaller groups and do a little bit of networking. There'd be an opportunity to do a couple of activities in there. Then we're going to come back to the main room where we'll do some share outs. We'll do a couple of poll questions for the teams. And then we're going to closing where I'll be able to share some announcements, and definitely don't want to miss out on that. All right. So now it's time for our icebreaker. This is going to be a fun way to kick things off. I have here in a moment a few prompts that I'm going to share with you all. And I'd like for you all to share your answers in the chat box. And what I'll do is I'll read out some of the answers as they come in. Okay. Sound good? All right. So here is the first one. So my fall vibe is A, pumpkin spice latte, pumpkin pie, pumpkin everything. Or is it B, maybe you're all about the fun decorations as soon as fall comes. I mean, I have a neighbor right now already has the Christmas lights up. So maybe you're that person. Maybe you're C, you're all about the boots. Honestly, here in Texas, it's not even that cold and I'm already rocking the boots. Or D, maybe you're like, is it spring yet? Is it summer yet? Maybe you're not a fall type of person. So let me go to the chat and see what folks are saying. Let me see. C, we got boots. B, with the decorations. My boots are made for walking. Love a good sweater too, I love that. Lots of boots, okay. Boots or either decorations. Yeah, boots or decorations. Give me the boots, yeah. Okay, we got one person who said A, there we go. That's something different. All right, B, C combo, yes. All right, so let's look now at the second one, the second slide, second prompt here, it's more about cosmetics. So I prefer a nude lipstick, although now that I'm looking at it, it looks more pink, but we're gonna call it nude. Or maybe you're B, maybe you're more into red lipsticks. Maybe you're C, you're all the lipsticks, you like all of the colors, you love to experiment. Or D, what lipstick? Maybe you're not a fan of the lipstick. Let's see. Okay. D, what lipstick? D, I'm a gloss gal. Yeah, I love that. A, because I like going natural. A, yeah, Sophia's really into the new lipsticks. A or B. Okay, Rosario with the red lipstick. There we go. Susie's combination between B and C. All the colors, says Jennifer. B for bold. Jennifer says D after this year. C, D, okay, a combo again. I basically only wear A or B, so the nude lipstick or the red lipstick. Every shade of A, every shade of nude lipstick, I like that. C, as in all of the lipsticks, A, nude lipstick, okay, I love that. There's a good combo, I love that. All right, so what's the next prompt? Let's go into the next prompt. All right. Some self-care theme here. I refuse to go without A, my face masks, B, my sunblock, C, my moisturizer, or D, my workouts. Or maybe it's something totally different. Maybe you can live with all of these, you know, and something totally different from you. Let's see here. The sunblock, refuse to go without the sunblock. Yeah, my moisturizer, let's see, my workouts. A, B, C, D, baby, that is my life. I love that, all of the things. C, again, the moisturizer, workouts. C, for sure, moisturizer. Mm-hmm. B, my sunblock. C, and B, yep, my sunblock. Okay, I feel like that was kind of the popular one. Actually, A, B, and C. Yes, I feel like these are all important, right? All right, what's the next one? The next prompt. If I can switch lives with someone, it would be someone who A, owns their own beauty shop, B, is a CEO of a skincare and cosmetics company, C, creates beauty products or formulas, or maybe it's D, maybe you want to be, you know, a beauty influencer for a day. What's it going to be? A, or is this from last time? What are folks saying? D, a beauty influencer. A and C. Yeah, C, creates beauty products. A, owns their own beauty shop. Maybe D? Maybe D. A, let's expand. C, creates beauty products. B and C. So you want to be a CEO and create the beauty products. B, does this mean I get to be Rihanna for a day? True, she is the CEO of her own company, isn't she? All right, Cool. And then let's go. I think this is the next one. I think is the last one. Yes, this is the last one. The best beauty advice is A, wear a smile and find time to laugh. B, inner beauty equals outer beauty. C, wear your favorite outfit and your best attitude. Or D, sleep 8 hours a night. Or again, maybe it's something totally different. We'd love to hear the kind of beauty advice you all have. Let's see, A, 100% with a smile. B, mental health is so important for outer beauty. Yeah. B, inner beauty. Yep. A, the wear a smile one. All of them. I know. I feel like they're all really great. B, absolutely, with the inner beauty. All of them are great. B and D, inner beauty, and then sleeping 8 hours. That's so underrated. I feel like we all need to sleep more, you know? the B and D, perfect formula. So the inner beauty and the sleeping 8 hours. Yeah, for sure. All right. That was a lot of fun. I love that. I love games like this. All right. So thank you all for joining me and a whole group icebreaker. I do now want us to move into the company overview part and to officially welcome the Samwa team. So thank you all so much for joining us today. We're looking forward to learning more about you all and the amazing work that you all do. And I'm really excited to introduce and share a little bit about Jennifer Sowell, who's going to do a company overview. So a little bit about her. As the SVP of Samwa Beauty, Jennifer combines her insatiable curiosity for both people and planet with her passions for green chemistry, sustainability, product innovation, consumer behavior, and data science to bring clean, thoughtful beauty formulations to the next generation of consumers. Her success over the past 17 years as a CPG expert, and maybe you can explain what that means, and brand builder is seen in her ability to merge strategy, leadership, and development to create unique hyper-growth omni-channel businesses. Over the course of her career, Jennifer has been incubating brands and implementing strategies for beauty companies such as Beauty Counter, Dermstore.com, and Freeman Beauty Labs. Well, so welcome, Jennifer.
Hi, everybody. So nice to be able to share this time with you guys. Thanks so much for joining us. And also thank you to the Step Up team. That was a really awesome icebreaker. And obviously, we're so gracious and so happy to be a part of this experience today. Thank you, guys. You guys are awesome. Well, we are really excited to introduce you guys, not only to our business, because our business has so many different pillars to it, but also to be able to describe the beauty industry and what's called CPG overall, because I think in terms of business and different kind of careers that you might look into, there is such a vast number, not only of positions, but interests that you might take in CPG, which means consumer packaged goods. So CPG encompasses any consumer good you could possibly imagine. So imagine something that you have at home that you use as a cleaning product. That's CPG. That's a consumer packaged good. It's something that's consumable. Even a toy, or even sometimes specific accessories. It's a vast world, CPG. Beauty is one facet of it. The beauty industry is one of the fastest growing and largest industries in the world. It's a $450 billion industry worldwide. So you can imagine, you know, tech leading the way, we're right underneath, which is really quite cool. But at the same time, when you heard the team mention that, you know, I have a profound passion for clean beauty, for sustainability, that comes with the responsibility that our company is built off of, which is one of the four pillars, which is really focusing on what we're doing to make a difference in our industry, and how we're taking into account the humans that are consuming our products, and how also what we put into the world, how it affects the environment. So there's a lot of different things to think about. Number one, what sector of business we're in. Number two, who we're servicing. So what types of consumers? And number three, how are we being just super, super responsible with what we're putting out there? And it takes a lot of checks and balances to kind of put these pieces in motion, and to also, you know, set the standards for ourselves and make sure that we're always adhering to those things. So CPG is consumer packaged goods. I've been in the industry for a little over 17 years building brands, so I'd consider myself a brand builder. And I really, really focused very much on the first part of my career in product development. And so I saw a lot of interest during our icebreaker of those wanting to be product developers, which is such a fun job. It is such a hard job, but it's a blast. It's also one where you have to have a really analytical mind, and you're doing so much more than playing around with goop. You're really taking that responsibility of how you're putting formulas together. Chemistry is real. it's not just, you know, magic thrown into a bottle. There's a life cycle to everything that we do. And so that's what makes what we do so magical and also so challenging at the same time. So there's so many different things that I could talk about and go on forever about with our industry, but I only have 10 minutes to do this. So I just want to make sure that I get, you know, some important highlights out to you. So we talked about CPG. I think one of the other important things for everyone really to understand is how businesses are structured. So beauty businesses have some roles that are probably a bit stronger than they might be in other types of businesses or other types of companies. And then depending on the size of your business, you may or may not have particular roles, or you might have people wearing more hats than they normally would. So in a team like ours, we've been in business for 3.5 years in the mass market. So we sell to mass retailers and also on our own website, D2C. That means direct to consumer. So we call, when you're selling to retailers and online, that's called omni-channel. So you have multiple channels in which you're selling through to consumers. And, it's very exciting. And of course, it's very challenging because you're trying to make sure that you have team members that are able to service all the different needs of all of those lines of business. So yeah, we are in fact an omni-channel business. And when I look to outline kind of the buckets and kind of roles that we have at our company, I'm happy you guys got to write this down. We have several kind of layers in which we work. And then what's also interesting about us is we have what's called a parent company. So there is a larger company that owns us. They're called Jax Pacific, and we are one of many brands that they own in CPG. So consumer product goods. And Jax Pacific also has a intensive focus on toy. There was a few other different divisions that the company has, like costumes. It's also another CPG type business. So there's a lot of different businesses that they oversee. So operationally, we lean on them. So all the brands use Jax Pacific for its operations. So one of the major buckets for any business is operations. And there's many varied facets to operations. In the beauty industry, there's a few other things that fall under operations that wouldn't at other companies. One of those is what's called quality assurance. So QA is something that's really important in our business, because anything that we're manufacturing and bringing to the consumers needs to have a quality check. And so we have really intensive policies and procedures for how all of our products are checked after they've been manufactured. Another part of operations is also our regulatory. So we have what's called a regulatory, this particular human being, or cosmetic regulatory, this particular human being almost acts like a lawyer, and we love these people, where they have a very intensive understanding not only of chemicals, but also what types of rules and regulations and common practices and testing that things need to be done before we bring something to market. So there's a lot of really, you know, interesting rules. Those two types of rules wouldn't exist at any other company typically, but we have an intensive quality assurance and regulatory that we lean on quite heavily. And then the other thing that sits very tightly knit with operations is product development. So in product development, you're not just taking colors and making fun creams. You are working operationally, cross-functionally with operations at all times. So you're constantly talking to the quality assurance people and teams, as well as your regulatory. So that's kind of a fun fact that all of these particular buckets and different groups of the organization, they all work together and they all work cross-functionally. So that is very exciting. How am I doing on time, by the way, guys? Am I running over already? Okay, good. Just wanted to make sure. So you've got operations, and I just described a few things that are part of that. So we've got quality assurance, we have regulatory, we also have finance. So finance is part of that. Our warehousing is part of that. So you have to think about where all the products are coming to and where they're getting shipped out. So that's kind of an intensive piece of operations. And I mentioned finance as well. So operations is a really intensive, there's a lot about what the operations, the back ends of everything that's happening on a day-to-day basis. That's operations. Product development. So I know that's something that everybody had interest in. Product developers are really working intensively with marketing. So marketing and product development have this really beautiful marriage where we're working in lockstep to come up with unique products. We're really looking for what's called white space in the marketplace. So things that haven't been addressed yet. What's a cool way to come up with a micellar water or something to remove makeup? What are the competitive ingredients out there? What are other brands doing? What can we do differently? Trying to identify those and then really going after a intensive development process where we define all the major questions. What should it feel like? What should it look like? What should be in it? What kind of package should it go in? Or maybe we don't know yet, but we have a direction that we want to go in. And so typically what marketing and product development will do, we'll put a brief together that is a working document that we all work and march towards. And then what's really fun is we add in our friends in creative. So we have a creative department that works on all of our packaging, all of our web development, all of our social, and I'll get to that in a minute. So that brief becomes this Bible for every project that you do, and it's shared cross-functionally throughout the team, and actually is one that you would share with operations because they're helping you set up your item numbers. They're helping you identify all of the details of the dimensions of the package that you're creating. There is so many devil in the details that all gets communicated from this brief throughout all the teams. So yeah. So there's a lot of different roles that I would love to get into. You're going to learn more when we do in our breakout sessions, but let's run through our deck a little bit so you can learn a little bit more about us before we do that. So one thing that we really focus on at C'est Moi is clean beauty. And the reason why we're different, we are an EWG verified brand. So we've taken all of our ownness and understanding of clean and green chemistry and taken it a step further with it, a verification with the EWG. So we really find that as a differentiation in the marketplace. The beauty industry has never, ever been regulated. So we describe us as a new generation of clean beauty. So we're focused on thoughtful formulas that address very sensitive and blemish-prone skin types. We don't put any fragrances in our products, and we really focus on that clean EWG verified ingredients that we use in all of our products. So go to the next slide. So as I mentioned before, you know, we're about addressing a white space, and I'm sure you hear about clean beauty all the time. And it's tough. Our industry, like I mentioned before, it isn't regulated. And as you guys get out into the world, you're gonna start to see there's many different industries that aren't regulated. I'm sure you guys have heard a lot about CBD. There's even other financial companies and other types of institutions out there doing different things. And there's loopholes and people get around them. So beauty has not been regulated in the United States. So we want to take it upon ourselves to do the right thing, to do the right testing, to make sure that we're being transparent, to make sure that we're showing consumers that there is a purpose to purchase. And so everything that we're doing is kind of wrapped up in an opportunity to show the world what we're made of and to show them that we have the same, just the same values that they do. We are very focused on Gen Z because this particular demographic, which is you, just really hasn't had the best products out there being made for very delicate and sensitive skin types. And so that's what we set out to do. And beyond that, we're a very accessible brand. So it's about being affordable and creating something really clean and special for everyone. So this is basically our breakdown of claims. And marketers, we work really hard on what this claim language is and making sure that we can substantiate it. So what that means is that we can back this up with, you know, with documentation, you know, that there is no animal testing. We don't test on animals. That would actually be an extra step that we'd have to deal with and quite frankly would never do. Our sunscreens are reef safe. We only formulate with zinc oxide. Recently the FDA has been known to approve certain sunscreens that are chemical sunscreens, and they do. They harm the environment, and they're not the greatest for our skin. So that's where zinc oxide mineral sunscreens are really important to us, and that's why we have them in the marketplace. We're EWG verified, so we're really proud of that. All of our products has gone through a very rigorous process to get verified. So every single ingredient has been evaluated by the EWG, not only for their percent inclusion, but what happens when they're all mixed together. So that is very important. All of our products are hypoallergenic. That means that our products have been tested on very, very sensitive skin types, and we have to ensure that they're passing with flying colors, that no one is having any irritations or any reactions in the skin. We do talk about clean ingredients, so we're also dermatologist tested. So that's a breakdown of our claims. And then the next few slides give you a breakdown of the different lines that we have. And you can always find more information on us on SaeMoi.com and also on our socials at SaeMoi Beauty. But this is a breakdown of our gentle skincare line. And we've got, you know, some really great products to support your everyday skincare. So a gentle foaming cleanser, a moisturizer, a sunscreen, and ways to remove makeup. Go through the next slide. And we've got our blemish skincare. So this is a chance to kind of clarify the skin, and that supports that basic gentle line, and these are your add-ons to clarify skin. And then if you go through the next few slides, we've got awesome face masks that we love, and we've got amazing sun care. I just mentioned bath and body, and then color cosmetics. So again, it's having a 360 approach to your daily life, that you are having clean opportunities at every stage of your beauty routine. So yeah, that's us. We launched a capsule collection with Liza Koshy. So that was another breakdown of that too. But you guys will get to see everything on our website.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Jennifer. That was really fun to hear. All right. So up next, we will be moving into a breakout room for the next few activities. So first will be our sort of speed networking session, which will be a great time for the teens, for you all on the call, to ask the staff at SaeMoi about their jobs and their career paths towards the beauty industry. So if you are curious about entry into the industry and how to excel within it, or maybe you're just trying to figure out if this is the right path for you, this is your chance to learn more and to take sort of what serves you. In fact, you'll be able to work on an activity to sort of think through the steps you might take to get into this type of industry. Also during this portion, definitely, you know, you want to, and while you're listening to the mentor share their experiences, be thinking about how all of this fits into your own skills and your own interests and how you personally can explore different roles in this industry, even beyond our session today. We want you all to walk away from today's event knowing that you have the complete ability to decide on and shape your own path. And so we hope you find the right knowledge and inspiration from your mentors. And then for the company activity, you all will get to work together on creating a product. And with this, you'll have the chance to ask yourself, do I see myself in this space and in this industry? So in the group, you're going to have a step up group facilitator. They're going to explain the instruction again. And if you have any questions, they'd be happy to help out. All right, so let's get started. How are we doing on the group setting, Amanda?
We're all set. We're ready to go.
Okay, perfect. All right, have fun, y'all. All right. Welcome back, everyone. I'm really excited to hear about how your experience in the breakout group went.
Hi.
So to recap, you all had the opportunity to network with same staff in your group, and then you all collaborated on a worksheet and a company activity where you all had the to come up with the new SEMA product for teens. So hopefully you all had the time to go through it all, but totally okay if you didn't. So let's hear how you all did. What were the results? Elle, who will be speaking for your group?
Yeah, so I believe Rosalie's is going to be briefly sharing out. I think that's if she's okay with that. We'll hear from her. Because Amelia's speaker wasn't working. Oh, okay, perfect. Go ahead. I'll share my screen, Rosalie's, and then you can go ahead and present the product that we created in our breakout group. Rosalie's, there you are.
Okay. So can you hear me?
Yes, we can.
So the name of our product is called Hyperlite. So we will make sure that this product is clean and gentle for our skin. So it can have the following ingredients like undergo proper testing, free from sulfates, plus parabens. Be mindful of ingredients and products, as well as omitted from the product. Vitamins as active ingredient and skin.
Thank you so much for sharing. I know that we actually kind of ran out of time for this one. We actually spent more time on the career steps worksheet. So I'm not sure if she wants to share about that too, but that was amazing. So, and our mentors had a really great time with both Amelia and Rosalie. So thank you so much for sharing.
Awesome. Thank you. Yeah, let's show her some love in the chat. You did an amazing job. Thank you so much for sharing. All right, so with that, let's jump into some poll questions. Take a few moments to answer some poll questions for the teens on the call here. We do value your feedback and we'd love to see how we did. And I believe in a second, yep, there it goes. A poll should pop up and I'm gonna give you all a few seconds to fill that out. Which is, says, it should say after this session, how much do you know about the skincare and cosmetics industry? Perfect. Okay. All right. So here's the second one. After this session, I feel confident in my ability to assess the skincare and cosmetics industry and decide whether or not it is a good fit for me. Give y'all another few seconds for this as well. All right, so thank you everyone. Again, we really appreciate your feedback. All right, unfortunately, we have come to the closing of our event, but before you go, here are a few important announcements starting out with our events. So first we have Latinx Girls Town Hall presented by Comcast NBC Universal. This is gonna take place on October 7th. You got different time zones here, but it's basically 4 p.m. Pacific time. It's gonna be 75 minutes long on Zoom. This is program for that is open to Latina high school teen girls and or gender expansive teens, Latina women between the ages of 18 and 23, and or gender expansive young adults. We also invite Latina women mentors and gender expansive adults to mentor at this program. Then we also have Career Steps in STEM with Google. That's going to be October 13th at 2 p.m. Pacific time. Again, 75 minutes long on Zoom. And this is a program that is open to high school teen girls and or gender expansive teens. And this session is open to mentors from Google as a partnership benefit. And then we also have Career Steps in Media and Entertainment with Comcast NBC Universal on November 2nd at 2 p.m. Pacific time. Again, 75 minutes long on Zoom, and again, open to high school teen girls and gender expansive teens, and open to mentors for NBC. All right, so check out our calendar, because there's more events there that you can find. Definitely add this all to your calendar. All right, so speaking of more events, up next we have Fly Together. So Fly Together is a free mentorship program featuring 4 online sessions on Wednesday, so October 27th, November 10th, December 1st, and December 16th from 4 to 6 p.m. Pacific time. Applications for this is open right now. The deadline is October 8th, and decisions are emailed on October 20th. And then we also have really exciting news here. So we have a new Step Up Mentorship community application and platform that we'd love for you all to join. You can connect with mentors and peers across the country on this platform. You can find additional resources. You never get to miss out on any upcoming news or events. Check out the chat box to get access to our code to join our community platform. And then, we definitely want to stay in touch, right? So text BOLD to 76278 to sign up for Step Up and receive reminders about our upcoming events. If you want to follow us on social media, we'd love to have you, where you can find us at Step Up Women's Network. And then if you want to connect with us, if you have any questions, you want to share feedback with us, you can feel free to email us here. On the slide, you can find Elle and also my email there. So you can copy and paste, take a screenshot, all that good stuff. All right, so what's the next slide here? Oh, okay, this is exciting. So first of all, our teen attendees will get a free discount code from Semoi. The only thing it is, you do have to pay for your own shipping and handling. Still really awesome of Semoi to do this. And so we'll definitely make sure to look for our emails for this discount code. And then on top of that, Semoi is also giving away a free prize from Semoi with Semoi products, which is really amazing. So one of our attendees is going to be our winner, which according to this, we chose it at random. It's going to be please don't hate me if I mispronounce your name, Rosalys. I think is what I heard.
You did it right.
Oh, good. good. I'm glad. Make sure to send your full name and your address to Morgan. So that way you get your prize from Semoi. So that's really exciting. Congratulations. All right. So what is next? So we want to thank you so much to all the mentors at Semoi for being here and sharing your time and insight with all of us. Special kudos to Jessica and to Jennifer for helping us put together today's amazing content. Of course, we definitely want to thank all of our teens today for always stepping up. And then we hope you found, we really hope that you found today's event helpful and hope to see you all again at the next event. So thank you so much and goodbye, everyone. Have an awesome evening. For afternoon.
Thanks everyone. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Great. Bye.